Hello there, adult lovers. So today I have a review of a few things that I got while I was in town visiting my family in Muskogee. Today I'm not feeling too good. My back really hurts, so I'm just gonna loaf around in my pajamas. Yay, Supergirl! And just show you what I got. So when I was at Walmart, I found the new character line for the Little Monster High Mega Construct dolls. And I don't have either Abby or Nefera. I haven't been able to find them here in Tulsa, so I picked these up immediately. I do like that they included paint on her arm to make it look like one sleeve, like her outfit, but they didn't do that for Abby, so her arms look very bare, because we always see her with the white fluffy things. And the picture on her box, the picture on the box in the back shows her wearing a bracelet, and she doesn't have that. I wonder, is that down at the bottom or something? Alright, well anyway, then a couple of days later, I went to a store called Walls, and it's a discount store, and it used to be really crummy. I mean, it was all hodgepodge, a big mess. The store closed down, then it got refurbished, repainted, reorganized, and it looks fantastic. I mean, the paint job on the walls is spectacular, but it's organized. And then I guess they felt they needed to, like, up the prices on things. So I went in there, and I saw some Boo York Monster High dolls marked for $21.99. I'm like, you didn't even find them for $21.99 when they were on the shelves at Walmart. They were $14.99. But they were having a half-off sale, so the dolls would have been like $10.50. But that still irks me that this discount store had their prices inflated. But because they were having 50% off sale, I did buy some things. So I bought this Bratz Fashion Pack, because my daughter now has a few Bratz dolls, but she has the original Bratz. These big ass feet, these are like twice as big compared to the feet of normal Bratz. But I figure, why not? Her dolls could use a few clothes. And besides, these can also fit Monster High dolls, so I might borrow them. And then I also got this Legend series of Spider-Man. This is Beetle. And it comes with a leg of a character, and you're supposed to put together Absorbing Man, right there. It comes with a ball and chain, and these apparently are all the characters that include a body part for you to be able to build. Can't say I really know that much about Beetle. Or really Spider-Man in general. I mean, it's not one of my favorite comics, but I've never seen her. So I don't know if she's new or she's just one of those, you know, unpopular ones. But hey, at least I didn't have any wire twisty ties and stuff. I'm just gonna toss this. I'm not gonna need it. That's not the bad thing about these dolls, that these action figures that are like, hey, buy the whole set and you can assemble this other character. It's like, well, that's great if I want to, but if I just want the one character I want, then it makes it a little difficult. It's like, great, now I've got a body part that I don't need. I hope I'm doing this right. Is that the... Okay, larger wings on top, and... yeah, that's right. Okay, so they just push into her back, like so. Her wings are very dragonfly, fairy-like. They're pink. And they can, on the hinge, turn, so they're horizontal. She wears an outfit of black and, it's definitely purple, even though it looks pink on the screen. It's purple. Kind of like a corset over a leotard or, you know, unitard outfit. How the heck would she breathe in this thing? Because there's like, her face is covered up. I don't know. Anyway, she's cool. Even though the box was marked $16.99, I only ended up paying $8 for her. So that was good. And then we have Bratz. So, you know, I was surprised to hear that Bratz was getting a reboot, but I figured that they would have improved on them by maybe not having the peg feet, by actually making them have feet, then you make shoes for them. But that wasn't the case. They basically just brought the line back out again with a few makeup changes and name changes, but then they make the feet ginormous, and it was really off-putting for me because I used to have a pretty damn big Bratz collection back when they were popular. They were the doll of the year. They had knocked Barbie off her pedestal. They had hot outfits, sassy faces. I loved them. I was crazy about them. And it was almost like an addiction. Every time I had money, I was just like, I gotta go get a new Bratz doll. And I donated them when there was people in need. So I just gave up the whole collection without a second thought. There were, thinking back now that it's been like 10, 12 years later, there were maybe just a few I would have liked to keep. I had the Masquerade line. That was really beautiful. But anyway, I digress. The feet were something to get used to, of course. But I still like the shoes. I even had little Bratz. They were so adorable. And then My Scene Barbie came out, and they were just blatantly copied off of them. And at the time, I just did not care for My Scene Barbie at all. I didn't like their faces. I didn't like anything except for their clothes. I actually got a couple of fashion packs, even though I never bought any of the dolls. Which, it's like, people are like, well, you can't just like one thing and you know, you gotta like it all or nothing. I'm like, no, I can have my preference. Oh, ow. So we have a Chloe and a Sasha. I still remember their names. Sasha is this beautiful African-American girl, dark skin. She's got a sunflower dress, a cute little I Love You shirt, and boots. And these boots are like a tan fleshed color and brown with studs. And then we have Chloe here with the rose shirt. I really love the shoulder bearing straps. I gotta think about that. And then these jeans that have a red seam line. And then she comes with these ugly, chunky, big ass feet with blue heel and gold accents, which doesn't even really look like it goes with this outfit. I mean, there's just nothing in her color palette of her outfit that corresponds with these shoes, but whatever. At least with something this big, maybe my daughter won't be able to lose them. And she sure as hell can't choke on it, because it's like she's not putting that in her mouth. So anyway, I got those. Alright, well, let's get to these little Monster High ones before we take up too much time. Oh, okay. There's the little bracelet. That's what I thought. I couldn't see it behind the packaging. And this series, the package is different from the one that I've been seeing. So this looks like notebook paper and everything. The ones that are included in this line are Nefera, Claudine, Abby, Laguna, Twyla, and that stupid new ghost, Ari Hauntington. It's like, yeah, you try and tell me that you haven't replaced Spectra when you have yet to make a Spectra doll ever since Ari came out. Don't lie to me, Mattel. I know what you're doing. So, each doll comes with a cute little eye coffin. Abby's gets a lime green and Farrah gets a coral pink. I think I'll switch that. I think the green one would look better with Farrah. And then we have the cuff. Ooh, that thing popped out. That went right in between. Okay. There we go. And we'll give her the green phone. I love Farrah. She's one of my favorites. And I just got a first edition Abby not too long ago. And I've been wanting to have one of these as her own little doll, because right now I'm using a Lala Loopsy Ice Queen. So this can now go into Abby's room for her to snuggle up with, because it's a little cute doll of herself. I do like how you can take the hair off, the head off, and then she's got this fur trim, which can also come off. I've got a few other ones. I have Spectra, and Venus, Cleo, and Gulia. Now, the one thing I really like is that Abby's base is a clear blue one, so it looks like ice. Come on, get your big feet in the pig. There we go. Nefera's is a dark purple one, like all the rest. There we go. So yeah, she gets her own little ice. Alright, so that is it for my little Muskogee shopping haul, I guess I could say. Stay there. Alright, right there. And thank you guys so much for watching. Please stay tuned for more reviews. Thank you and bye.